Happy Sunday, everybody. What's up? Welcome in to another episode of the Daily Juice Podcast. I am your host, Matt Perrault. You guys can follow me across all socials at Sports Talk Matt. This podcast, OmahaSteaks.com. That is our title sponsor. And if you are making money in college football, there are two different ways to say thank you. Well, three, I guess. You can just say thank you. The other way would be to, well, buy Omaha Steaks products. 50% off sale going on right now at OmahaSteaks.com. They'll knock off $30 additionally with the promo code JUICE at OmahaSteaks.com. Go check out everything they got available over there and give us some credit with the promo code JUICE. Check that out, or go to BettingPros.com/shop and go buy a hat or a t-shirt to help spread the word about the Daily Juice. Now, in the NBA, I was very hot. I won 22 units last year during the NBA season. This college football season is approaching that level of just ridiculousness. You know, you just get hot in certain sports and you ride it, okay? I'm not hot in the NFL. In fact, I'm just back to being level here with the NFL. And we're going to have five or so units in play coming up here today in the NFL. We'll see how that goes. But the record in college football is now officially 31-15, up 14.4 units. Now, that doesn't include the loss that I put out for Texas Moneyline on the Discord channel, personal play. It doesn't include the win, though, on the over 60 in that game. Nor does it include the win for North Carolina, laying 9.5 yesterday. That came in. So a lot of personal plays out there. Official plays are the record, in case you're curious. When I mention something, if I don't say it's official, it doesn't go on the record, okay? So yesterday in college football, we get the under. I have no idea. The Iowa game should have gone over. We got very lucky there. Iowa game stayed under. The Alabama game pushing was ridiculous. 46 on the number. Whew, that was incredibly fortuitous. So 1-0-1 there. That was good because it got a little shaky. Michigan was a walk. That was easy. Colorado was the hook. 3.5. Most pros bet 6, 5, 4.5, 4. I got in late. I got in at 3.5. I got lucky. So there we go. We got that on the right side. The Buffaloes win, but do not cover on the road at Arizona State. Third consecutive week fading the Buffaloes. Third consecutive week of making money fading the Buffaloes. So keep that in mind. They do not do well against the spread. So more money-making opportunities in the future this season with Colorado. So that's a 3-0-1 mark in college football. We don't track the pushes. It never happened. So we don't even keep track of the pushes. It's either a win or a loss, in case you're curious about the record. Like, where are the pushes on the record? Don't keep track of it. That's just brush it aside. It never happened. Wins and losses only. Baseball was the only loss. And man, the Rangers had 8 hits and 3 runs, and we couldn't get one more run from the Rangers. They win the game 3-2. That was a bummer. Or it could have been a 4-0-1 day. It could have been a 4-unit day. Fortunately, it turns into just a 2.9-unit day, but which is not horrible. Okay, so now we're up. We're playing with some house money here, and we can kind of do some fun things and, you know, get into it. I'm going to tell you at the top, I hate this card. Straight up hate this card. I think the Bills are going to win and cover against Jacksonville. Okay, I do believe that. I'm going to have a personal play on it. I'm not going to make it official. But I do think if you're looking for something really early in the morning, you're like, Matt, that first game standalone, what do you think? Bills. Bills -5. Live number right now at the time of taping is 4.5 at circa. 4.5. It's 4.5 or 5.5. You actually could arb that if you wanted to. Some big discrepancies here between some books have got a lot of money on the Bills. Some books have a lot of money on Jacksonville, which is kind of surprising, but you know, I like the Bills. So that's the first game. I really don't like this card. Okay, if you're looking for survivor picks, either it's the Dolphins or it's the Lions. I would take the Dolphins. Okay, that would be my survivor pick. If you're looking for one, I would take the Dolphins. I got 3 picks for you here on the podcast. We will do the live stream coming up at noon Eastern time. Pat Fitzmaurice is back with me on the live stream. Looking forward to talking with him for a half an hour or so. 12 o'clock noon on the Betting Pros YouTube channel. I will give out a long teaser which hit for the first time last week, and there are a bunch of options for Wong teaser. So we'll get to that on the on that pod, and then four player props that I am betting as well. Coming up here for this game, this series of games here for week five of the NFL. So hopefully you guys will join us noon Eastern, 9 p.m. Pacific time on the Betting Pros YouTube channel, live stream for 30 plus minutes or so with myself and Pat Fitzmaurice. Okay, but the three official plays I'm going to give you guys. It's Steelers and it's the Ravens. Look, the Steelers are going to try to make Kenny Two Gloves play. I'm not really sure why. He's not healthy. He has a bone bruise. This Ravens defense is not great, but it's Harbaugh, and it's going to be good enough to really slow down that offense. That offense can't do anything for the Pittsburgh Steelers. The Ravens have injuries all over the place. I think the Ravens win the game, but I think the easier play on this is the under. It's 38. This number has come down dramatically from open. At 41.5, we're down to 38 now. I'm going to trail the steam here, and I think 38's a good number. I don't want 37.5. I want 38, so find a 38. The number matters, as we saw yesterday with Colorado. The number matters with Alabama, 46, not 45.5. Number matters, okay? 38 matters. I just don't think we're going to see a lot of points. The last three games played between these two teams, and you look at in Pittsburgh with the Ravens on the road, 36.5, 44.5, 41.5 all went under. And I know injuries to the fact that Lamar Jackson wasn't playing in a lot of these games. I understand all of that, but three in a row, four of the last five have gone since 2018 being played at Pittsburgh. This is going to be the Steeler crowd will be at full throat. They're going to be loud. They're not, they hate Matt Canada, but they know their offense can't score. So their defense has to play really well. I think the under is a solid play here. Under 38, Pittsburgh and the Baltimore Ravens here in the black and blue division in the AFC North, under 38 for 1.1 units. Now, the game of the day is San Francisco taking on the Dallas Cowboys. Here's the thing. This number hasn't moved. 3.5. Niners, 3.5. Goes to 4, they take Dallas. Goes to 3, they take San Francisco. 3.5. It's a perfect number. In-game this. Okay? This is an in-game play from a side perspective. I think San Fran wins the game, but I want like -1 or a pick. I got Texas yesterday. They were laying 5.5 at close. I got money line at -120 for Texas. Now, they lost the game, and you could make a lot of cases for how poorly that game was coached at the end for Steve Sarkisian. Sark really screwed that end of that game situation up. And look, Quinn Ewers, interception that was horrible early. Interception in the red zone, which was horrible early. Fumble in the red zone, which is horrible. I mean, Texas should have won that game. I mean, it's stunning that Oklahoma won the game, and then they could have been calling timeouts to save time for themselves. They let Oklahoma go down there, score a touchdown with 16 seconds left. I didn't understand any of it. I think he froze. I don't know. It was bizarre. He looks like our defense is going to win this for us right now. Okay, dude. I mean, I guess so, but yikes. I just think this is a brawl. I like the Niners, but 3.5 concerns me because of how much money is being bet on both sides. I think the best play in this game is the under 45.5. Now, you might go, well, Matt, really? 45.5? That seems kind of low here for two teams that are really going to go after it and attack each other. I know Micah Parsons is not 100%. No digs as well for Dallas, but both teams are 2-2. Last game against Arizona for San Francisco, 44 was the total. They gave up 16 points, 35-16. Against the Giants at home, 43.5. The game went under, 30-12. Against the Rams, it went over. Against Pittsburgh, it went under, 30-7, the win on the road. This is also at home here for San Fran, completing this three-game homestand that they've had. For Dallas, last week against the Patriots, at home, 38-3. That's all they gave up. Were 3 points. Okay? So against Arizona. They lost, gave up 28 points against the Jets. They gave up 10 against the Giants. They gave up zero. They can score. I just don't think they're going to score up against this defense. I think we're going to see two very good defenses. I think Brock Purdy might have a tough night. I think Brock Purdy to throw a pick, maybe a prop for tomorrow, take a look at. I think Brock Purdy struggles a little bit here. Dallas has the number one scoring defense in the NFL. San Fran, number three. While I don't really know what to do with, and I know offensively, San Fran's number three in points scored per game, and Dallas is number four. I get all of that. Points per play, or so yards per play, San Fran number two, Dallas number seven defensively. On the other side, Dallas number 16 offensively, San Fran number three defensively. This is a playoff game, right? This is old school. This is like when I was growing up, the Cowboys and the Niners. This is a big darn deal, okay? Easily for me. I think this is going to be an absolute barn burner on top of the fact that it's a primetime game. And primetime games tend to stay under 45 and a half. Dallas and San Francisco, 1.1 units. Live bet for the side. I like San Fran. I want under a field goal, though. I don't want 3.5. I want 2.5 or less for San Francisco here up against Dallas. And one final bet, my teaser, which has been pretty good, 3-1 so far on the year. I am a big believer in what's going on with Indianapolis. They're getting Jonathan Taylor back. He's going to play. Him and Anthony Richardson, I think, are a dynamic duo after what happened last week where they were down by 20 at home to the Rams and they came back and covered. I'm back on Indianapolis, okay? I think this team getting Taylor back is a huge lift. He signed a 3-year deal. He's there. How many carries? I don't know. I don't care. Plus 8.5. Indianapolis, plus 8.5. I think Indy might win the game outright, to be quite honest. Okay, the Titans on the road, AFC South battle. I think Indianapolis has a chance to win the game, and I think it's going to be really interesting. You say, well, Matt, you know, they can't really run the football against the Titans. Yeah, but they threw the ball well against the Rams. I don't like that pass defense for the Titans at all. Colts plus 8.5 at home in a divisional game. 43.5 is the total. This qualifies for a wong if we get closer to kickoff, but plus 8.5. And I'm in love with the Texans. Texans plus 2 on the road at the Falcons. I know Desmond Ridder's never lost a home game. Okay, I get all that. College or pro? It's 2. Total's 41.5. I like CJ Stroud. I like Nico Collins. I like Tank Dell. I like Damian Pierce. I like the defense even as to what's going on. D'Amico Ryans, rookie of the year. Haven't thrown a pick yet. I know on the road it's tough, but I don't like that Falcons team. I think they're fraudulent. What happened on the road in Jacksonville or against Jacksonville last week? They got annihilated. I think that's the real Falcons team. At home, they play better, but they should have lost to the Packers. We were on that game. We laid the 2. They won by 1. Should have lost that game. Texans plus 8.5. You can find 2.5s here in Vegas. Plus 8.5. Houston, plus 8.5. Indianapolis, plus 8.5. Two-leg teaser, 6-point teaser for minus 120. We're going to lay 1.2 units down on that. And that's it for right now, okay? I have a Wong teaser, and then I'll have 4 player props for us coming up during the live stream later on today, noon Eastern time. Let's close the week out strong. Let's have a good day. A good day equals a good week, a good winning week, okay? So, you know, we're up around 6 units or so on the week. So went into yesterday, I believe, like up 3 units, right? So we're doing fairly well. We'll do the whole accounting come on Monday, but let's see what today looks like. If you want to do Moneyline parlays, you can get involved with, I mean, Dolphins and the Lions are the 2 number one picks for Survivor. I like them both to win. Lions over Panthers, Dolphins over Giants. You can even throw in the Astros if you want, although you know me in baseball. But the Astros to beat the Twins today, it's a plus 136 3-leg Moneyline parlay. It's not a horrible idea if you want to jump in with those. I hate 3-leg Moneyline parlays, however. Just 2 legs, Dolphins, Lions. Doesn't get you, it's 275, minus 275. The juice is still super high just to bet on those 2 unless you want to lay 275. And if you do, be my guest. All right. Under 38, Pittsburgh and the Baltimore Ravens. Under 45.5, San Francisco and Dallas. Indianapolis plus 8.5. Tease with the Texans at plus 8.5. 3 bets for us here on a Sunday. Wong teaser still to come, plus 4 player props on the live stream. We'll have over 5 units in play here for the NFL. Talk to you later on today. My name is Matt Perrault. Follow me on socials at Sports Talk Matt each and every morning. The Daily Juice Podcast, always being brought to you by OmahaSteaks.com.